Good afternoon, YouTube community, guys and girls out there everywhere.
It's your boy Alexander saying, and I'm
gonna do before I get started on the sports opinion log, I want to give a special
shout out to one of my loyal Snapchat viewers
and follower and a good friend of mine, Bronx Boom Boom, who blessed me with some belated birthday Yankee gear, which I will definitely be showing off in the next snap as I talk about the Yankees and Chicago's and being down to the last strike. So again, shout out to Bronx Boom Boom. Her snap code will be posted before I start the sports opinion log and at the end, and welcome. And good afternoon, YouTube community, guys and girls. But in particular, on this segment of the Sports Opinion Log, the Yankee universe, which I now, until the day I die, pledge my allegiance to. And why is that? Well, one, I'm a New Yorker. Two, I'm born in the Bronx. And three, I had to come through because of what happened last night when literally down to the last strike, Brett Gardner hits a three-run shot and the Yankees take the first game from the defending champion Chicago Cubs in Wrigley Field. And y'all know I love interleague, so if you see me here on the Sports Opinion Log with the Yankee gear on talking about the Yankees, it's one, I'm either talking about the hated Red Sox, which I'll get into later, but right now I love my interleague. The Yankees took the first game. Right now, real time, as I'm making this video, the Yankees are currently stomping out the Chicago Cubs right now to the score of 8-2 in the top of the seventh inning. And there's a lot of beautiful stats that I just wanted to get into in regards to Brett Gardner's historic home run. And what makes it historic is that he is one of three Yankees to hit a game-winning home run when we're down to the last out. The first one was, the second one was, was Mickey Mantle against the Chicago White Sox in 1952 and the legendary Babe Ruth in 1923. Pretty amazing stats. And what's even more crazier, stats of course come from ESPN stats and information on this one. And in 1952 and 1923, the Yankees actually won the World Series. So hopefully this game-winning home run by Gardner is some foreshadowing for what I predict to be a wonderful, beautiful Yankee season, which will end with a World Series trophy coming back to New York where it rightfully belongs. Bronx, New York, that is. But I'm also gonna talk about something else, which is why I'm wearing my Yankee gear. Today is gonna be more of a historical lesson because of what happened last Monday. Now, all of you know, I love my baseball, I love my Yankees, I love my interleague. I only watch the National League during the playoffs, okay? Outside of interleague, of course. But I'm an AL guy, Yankees, Pinstripe Pride, Bronx Bomber, you know what it is. But something had happened, of course, in Boston, in hated fucking Boston, regarding an African American. So that's why I'm making this post, because Adam Jones said that he was berated by racist Red Sox fans and that peanuts, a bag of peanuts, was thrown at him on the field. And you know, for a player to actually have to talk post game about racial taunts and curses being hurled his way in 2017 is pretty much disgusting and unacceptable. But of course, this is Boston we're talking about. And you know, the Boston fans wanna give him a standing O. Oh, by the way, this happened last Monday, excuse me. And I'm talking about it now, because Boston fans wanna give him a standing O. Boston fans wanna say that they're not racist. And you know what? I'll agree with that. Boston Red Sox fans aren't racist. They're fucking racist pigs, okay? don't get it twisted. Just because we're here up north does not mean that the African American community is free from racism, especially up in Boston with those redneck, racist white people who clearly hate an African American man. Actually, I did some research and it seems that actually the whole organization of the Boston Red Sox hate African Americans, period. So I did some digging to find out about the racial history of the Boston Red Sox, and this is what I found out. Now mind you, Boston fans say they're not racist, but I can guarantee you that their organization is racist, and therefore their fans, as a result, you see the correlation. Nothing but racism. So here, let's take a little history trip here. I'm gonna have to browse on the notes on this one, so excuse the glare from the glasses. But here we go. On July 21st, 1959, there was a guy named Elijah Pumpsey Green, who appeared as a pinch runner for the Boston Red Sox at Comiskey Park, who became the first African American to play a Major League Baseball game in a Red Sox uniform. But guess what? 1959, 12 years after Jackie Robinson, the first African American man of color, broke the baseball racial barrier. It is a proven fact that the Red Sox, and the Boston Bruins, while we're at it, were literally the very last team in Major League Baseball to sign up for integration. It is also a fact that the Boston Red Sox organization as a whole were pulled before Congress twice for not having any African American person of color in their organization. Do you know what I'm talking about? We're not even talking about players. The Boston Red Sox organization was the last organization to have an African American person even working in their stadium. Concessions? The person that takes your ticket? The Boston Red Sox were the last team in baseball to have a person of color working for them, period. So guess what, Red Sox fans? You are fucking racist. Your history is mirrored, is stained, is tainted in blatant racism. So screw your standing ovation in 2017. The fact of the matter is that it happened. And as I'm digging through the history of the Red Sox, not only did the Red Sox wait until 12 years later to have an African American take to the field in their racist uniforms, they passed on not only Jackie Robinson in 1945, they passed on Willie Mays, because the general manager, Tom Yorkie, who was a well-known racist, who delved in cronyism, and cronyism means that you hire your friends. Well, actually, yes, your friends is cronyism, your family is nepotism. For those that don't know, when it comes to workplace environments and who you deal with, he had his cronies, his best friends worked in his organization. And when they scouted out Willie Mays, you know what they said about him in a scouting report? He wouldn't be a good fit for a Red Sox uniform. So I think you're pretty much telling me what I need to know, because the Boston Red Sox, the racist organization that they are, it is facts that they passed on two Hall of Famers in Jackie Robinson and Willie Mays. What more do you need to know? We can take it as recently as when Big Poppy and Manny Ramirez, two HGH and PED cheats who are smacking home runs here and there. But the reason why that they are held in high regard in Boston is, one, they brought a World Series to that racist town that didn't win one in over 95 years. 98 to be exact, when they finally did win one, and they're Dominican. Check out the Red Sox lineup during the Big Poppy and David Ortiz time. Yeah, Coco Chris was there for a minute, but if you look at the lineup and the history of the Boston Red Sox, you don't have a lot of African-American all-star players who played with Boston. And that's fine, because there's other teams to play for. But please, take note and know your history. The Red Sox are a racist team. They are a racist organization. Their fans are racist. That is the truth. Their standing ovation would be the equivalent to me as the white people that say all lives matter when you're talking about black lives mattering. And that's the issue. So there you have it. Last team in Major League Baseball to integrate. Oh, you know what? And I actually have something here which was on record coming from deceased general manager from like the 1900s, Tom Yorkey. His hand-picked manager, Michael Pinky Higgins, said there would be no niggers in this ball club as long as he had anything to say about it. So that'll pretty much be my ending statement. Fuck Boston, fuck the Red Sox, and fuck their fans, now and forever. Okay? You cannot escape your history, and your history is disgusting, and it is a blight. It is a stain, not only on baseball, but in society, in American society and African American society. Boy, there's nothing much more to say about that other than thank you for the views, the likes, the comments, the subscriptions. This is your boy Lex Anderson signing out. Oh, and before I sign out, I will once again stand and take my hat off in honor of the late, great, and current players of African American culture and pride and skin color. Those that played in the Negro Leagues in the 20s, 30s, and 40s because Major League Baseball didn't find us fit to play their game. And by the way, which is something also very scary, between baseball, NBA, and the NFL, the numbers of African American players playing in Major League Baseball in 2017 are pretty much mirroring the same way they did in the past. This is Lex Anderson signing off. Yankee Universe now and forever, baby. Mariano Rivera, there it is. New era fitteds, that's all I do. Thank you.